Adrian X, we pride ourselves on the comprehensive nature of our syllabus and our aviation industry experience. We incorporate everything vital for the safe and knowledgeable use of RPAs or drones in South Africa today. First, let's focus on the medical requirements. In accordance with the civil aviation regulations, every remote pilot must hold a Class 3 medical certificate issued by an approved aviation medical examiner. We suggest that the prospective RPL pilot obtains the certificate before commencement of the training. Applicants must be free from any risk factor, disease or disability, which renders them unable to perform assigned duties safely. A list of approved aviation medical examiners can be obtained from our office or from the SACAA website. The first part of the course focuses on the theoretical training. The theory course takes place over a period of 7 days, which normally commences on a Monday and will continue until the following Tuesday. Classes commence at 0900 and will finish at approximately 1500 every day. There will be an hour break for lunch, as well as 2 breaks for tea and coffee. 5 days are allocated to RPL theory and 2 days for the restricted radio license theory. The theoretical training consists of the following subjects: air law, principles of flight, aircraft technical, human factors, meteorology, navigation, and flight planning. Students will write an in-house examination upon completion of every subject as follows. There will be mock exams, after which the instructor will correct the answers, and then a final in-house exam invigilated by the instructor. Included in the course is the training towards the restricted radio license. The Civil Aviation Regulation stipulates that every remote pilot must be the holder of a restricted radio operator's license. The reason for that is that the remote pilot will operate the drone in airspace that is shared with other aircraft. The theoretical instruction will be conducted over a period of 2 days. The student will then be required to self-study with the assistance of the instructor. The radio exam is an online examination written at the South African CAA approved examination center. Upon successful completion of the examination, the student will be prepared for a practical test with an approved designated radio examiner. The training culminates in the last phase, which is the practical flight training, which will take place at one of our approved training fields. It will consist of 4 sessions of 2 hours duration each, during which the instructor will follow an approved syllabus. The last session will be conducted by our chief flying instructor, and it serves as a mock test. He will then issue a letter of recommendation to the designated flight examiner, who will conduct a flight test as per the prescribed SACAA standards. All of our instructors are either working drone operators, helicopter pilots, or airline pilots. What sets us apart from other drone schools is the high standards and technical requirements we adhere to in order to comply with all aviation laws and regulations. The course includes study materials for the theoretical exam as well as the restricted radio license. We will assist the student with the arrangements and bookings for external exams as well as the flight training schedules. The expected completion time for the course is approximately 3 to 6 weeks, depending on the availability of the student. Contact us today for more information on how to fly and earn a legal income with drones in South Africa.